I made a video previously on how to clone a hard drive to a solid state drive using a KUDOS software. In this video, I'm going to show you how to clone a drive using Macrium Reflect software. And the hardware you need is the same. You would need some kind of a SATA to USB adapter and just plug your hard drive in and the USB into the computer. Once that's in place, then you go into the software and you're going to want to choose to clone the disk. Now, even though it's showing that it's under the main C drive, it doesn't matter because we want to clone the other drive. So once you choose that disk, you can click on the link to choose a different disk as the source and then choose the one that you want to actually clone from. Make sure to select the disk, and then underneath that you can select the destination where it's going to clone to. So you'll find the disk in here, you can select, and you may see that the checkbox is now come unchecked for the source. So I didn't recognize that right away, which you may have the same thing, and you'll hit next and it says that it's not selected. So we have to go back here and put the check mark on there, and then we can continue. We're not interested in doing a schedule. This is a one-time thing, so we'll just bypass that. And you can scroll down and confirm that the settings are correct and it's exactly what you want. If it all looks good, you can hit finish. Otherwise, you can go back and make other adjustments. We only want to run this now. We don't want to save it. It's a one-time thing. So we'll uncheck that one option, hit OK, and then the process begins. And this can take quite some time to run, depending on the size of the drive that you're cloning and how fast it is or how slow it is in that case. There's many options also that you could choose in here for how to clone it. And depending if you're cloning a drive to use on the same computer, or if you're cloning it to be used on a different computer that has different hardware, then there's other options in here that you might want to look at that are really only available in the Pro paid edition of Macrium Reflect. This, what we're doing here, is strictly using the free edition. And we're doing this at 1,000 times the speed. So it did take about 45 minutes or so to run through the whole thing, but this is sped right up, and because of the length of it, I'm cutting out a big chunk of it. By the time the imaging process is complete, you'll see some screens pop up that show the drive letters, and when you close that, then you'll have the message saying that the cloning is complete. And that's it for this tutorial. If you did find it helpful, please do give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing for more. In the meantime, you can check out one of these other great videos that I've done for you. Thanks for watching. See you in the next one. Bye for now.